Please rewind this cassette.
Okay, guys, if you don't know, DC Fandom released a bunch of trailers in a single day. We got to look at the Suicide Squad by James Gunn. We got the Batman trailer from Matt Reeves. There was a new Wonder Woman 1984 trailer. And, of course, we got our first look at HBO Max's release of the Schneider Cut, or Snyder. As I like to call him, Schneider. Good old Zack Schneider. For the most part, all of the trailers received overwhelmingly positive reception. Wonder Woman 1984 looks epic. The Batman looks like a David Fincher movie. It looks like Seven. The Riddler's like a serial killer who, you know, puts no more lies everywhere. The Batman stuff looks great. Although I always knew Robert Pattinson would be a good Batman. I've loved Robert Pattinson ever since his transformative performance in Good Time. I'm very excited to see him in Tenet. Sorry I haven't been doing many videos lately. I've been recovering from a serious back injury. But I don't know if I'm going to react. Originally, I had an idea that I was going to react to all of the DC trailers in like one setting and watch all of them. So kind of marathon it. I thought would be fun. I don't know what they were thinking with this. This really was targeted towards Zack Snyder fans in particular. Because this looks terrible. I mean, I gotta get this out of the way. This is a terrible trailer. It's everything I hate about Zack Snyder. It's everything I hate about his trailers, his pretentious filmmaking style. I can't believe that people still defend this guy after all these years. I mean, people seem to forget that he was on his way out before he got the Man of Steel gig. Like, Sucker Punch was a bomb. Watchmen was a bomb. That Al movie he made didn't make that much money. And then Man of Steel was a major financial disappointment and made $43 million profit. It cost $225 million to make. It only made $643 million worldwide. That is very low when compared to so many other superhero movies that have come out the last few years. Then Batman v Superman comes out, $166 million opening weekend. It's going to make $1 billion. Makes $873 million. Has one of the biggest second week drops in history. Then, of course, the whole Justice League debacle happens. They bring in Whedon. So I don't mind any of that. What's been annoying me are the Snyder fans who have been defending this guy and have been claiming that Batman v Superman and Man of Steel are misunderstood masterpieces, that they're epic tragedies, that they're like great Greek tragedies, and that Zack Snyder's this great artistic genius that nobody understands. It's the way that people defend Michael Bay's Transformers films. I don't know how anyone could watch any interview with Zack Snyder, hear this guy talk, respond to anything, and not see this guy as nothing but an arrogant, simplistic, childish asshole. And that's what he is. He cannot handle complex subject matter. He's a very talented artist visually. I really like his Dawn of the Dead remake. I've said this. But Zack Snyder cannot. That's why Watchmen failed in a lot of ways. He couldn't handle the complexity of it. And visually, I'm getting tired of this. But I was hoping with this trailer, we would get some kind of sign of, oh, maybe this will be good, this Justice League trailer. Because I didn't hate the movie they released. It was a bad movie, but it was a fun B movie in a lot of ways. But it's just shocking to me that anyone can be positive about this except for hardcore Snyder fans. I don't even know what HBO Max is thinking. I don't know if they think like 20 million people are going to subscribe to HBO Max to watch the Snyder Cut. That's not happening. It just isn't. There is, I mean, the movie was going to bomb regardless. There's no alternate universe where the Zack Snyder version of the Justice League comes out and makes $1.5 billion. People always blame the bombing on the production issues and the movie being bad, but no one wants to consider that there was already momentum slacking off. And then people can't say that it was like, oh, well, it's just because of this, because then Aquaman came out and made $1.1 billion, and even before that, Wonder Woman made over $800 million. So the only DC movies, really, these major franchise DC films that have been disappointing, are directed by one guy. And if you point this out, people just make excuses for Zack Snyder. And I'm so sick of the excuses. So instead of it being a movie, they're going to do four episodes, each one being an hour. And then they gave Zack Snyder money to do post-production, and I think there's going to be some reshoots. But this is, I just can't believe this trailer. They use Hallelujah, that song, and it's just terrible. It looks exactly like Man of Steel and Batman v Superman. It's so dark and depressing and dreary and overwrought and ridiculous, and I'm just stunned by this. I thought they were going to release a really cool trailer to get people hyped up for this, and this looks pretty much as bad as the movie that came out. So let's look at it, but I'm not impressed with this at all. This was definitely the worst trailer released yesterday. And it's pretty pathetic. And you can call me a hater all you want. I don't care. The numbers are on my side. Critically, I've been correct. I mean, you guys can like the movies. I'm not saying that your opinion is invalid, but why can't you be honest with the fact that the DC Universe has been successful without Zack Snyder? The biggest film they've had in the last few years was Aquaman and Joker, and he didn't make those movies. I mean, could it be that Zack Snyder, his type of filmmaking just doesn't translate to the mainstream like these other directors? Joker cost $55 million, and Zack Snyder's been making these $200 million movies. Maybe there just isn't a big fan base for Zack Snyder anymore. I think we've moved on past 300 and that era. I don't think people like this kind of movie anymore. But kudos to HBO Max for doing it. I'll give them that they're actually taking a risk with this. Oh my god. It's just the song coming in. See, that looks terrible. This dark side, it looks terrible. That looks like really bad CGI. The background's terrible. I mean, it's just stunning to me. It's immediately a visually ugly film. That looks like a cutscene from a PS4 game. And that is not hyperbole. Thanos looks so much better than this. I know it's not probably finished CGI yet, but if this is supposed to make me think like, oh, they're going to make it, because, you know, the movie that they released looked like garbage. It was the most ugly $300 million film ever made. But this doesn't look good. That's really bad. Like right there. I mean, it's just, once again, just visual vomit. This looks horrible. That all looks fake. The background looks fake. None of this looks like it was shot on location. This is all just CGI. The screen is filled with way too much stuff. It's a mess visually. I mean, I'm stunned that this is what they put this out there. Like, this doesn't, like, that's a really, I mean, it's ugly. It's a very ugly shot. It's well composed and all that, but just too much in the computer. Wonder Woman. Batman looking at Superman in a hologram. The drinking shot that was in the other trailers. That's the thing. Why are they showing stuff that was in other trailers? We've already seen this footage. Like, I know they show some new footage, but why are we seeing this stuff that we already saw footage for? The football scene. Once again, look at that. Like, Zack Snyder trying to be David Fincher. He's always trying to be David Fincher. This looks like a commercial. Except David Fincher is actually a very intelligent filmmaker. But this reminds me of, like, the rowing sequence in Social Network. He's trying to have this, like, you know, something that looks like a commercial or a music video. Because none of this stuff was in the movie. A lot of this stuff wasn't in the final cut of Justice League. Right there, I hate the cheese here. The little girl smiling at her. This is going to be forced sentimentality. And, like, look, they're really emotional and sweet. And Wonder Woman's so great. I remember this in the trailer too, in the early trailers, and that wasn't in the movie either. Oh, he doesn't have shoes on. Okay. Why don't you have shoes on, Flash? I wonder if his feet get hurt running fast like that with no shoes. Or can the shoes not contain his speed? So he saves this girl, looks into his face dramatically. Now what makes you think, are they going to have a relationship that's a subplot? That's one of the 20 subplots that'll probably be in this 4-hour movie, because Zack Snyder loves to stuff as many subplots as he can. There's like 7 acts to Batman v Superman. Or is this just going to be this one moment? Oh my god. I mean, this is one of the better looking shots, because, you know, it's Batman and it looks cool. But once again, this background, like, oh my god, Snyder. Could you just try to not make something look like this? I mean, his biggest issue is that he's just, his screenplays are horrible and his story ideas are horrible and he's not very good with actors, and pacing a movie and editing is a big problem with him. The transitions in his movies are typically pretty bad, but I mean, I'm sorry, this just isn't like, the Batman trailer that just came out looks so much better than this, because it looks more realistic. It doesn't have this terrible look to it. The worst Lois Lane that we've ever had. Martha Kent. Don't care about these characters. Not iconic. That's kind of cool. That looks cool. All the Aquaman stuff always looks cool. Once again, very ugly. Looks like 300. Cyborg still looks terrible. they never really got the CGI right on Cyborg. I don't totally blame them. I think it was mishandled from the beginning as a design. Cyborg just is never going to look good. I don't even dislike the actor who plays Cyborg. I think it could be good. Notice they're not giving you, like, any dialogue or story details. They're just showing you, Dad, no! Dad! Hey, it's like Watchmen. Dr. Manhattan. Oh my god. I mean, Steph, that just looks so... It looks like shit. Like, this just looks so horrible. I'm just so stunned that they released this. I know Snyder fans are going to be eating this up. But I just... It's so crazy to me how fake this all looks. Like, just how poorly rendered a lot of this stuff is. I mean, they had so much money they put into this movie, hundreds of millions of dollars, and there's films with lower budgets than this that have much better looking CGI. Whoever handles the CGI on these DC films has really let Zack Snyder down, because he's not a special effects guy, so I don't totally blame him. It's not like he's doing all of the work. Whoever the team is behind these movies has really let him down in the Justice League film, particularly. Man of Steel had pretty good CGI. For the most part, it was just visually all over the place. And there's like a 45-minute fight scene at the end that's the most boring thing in the world. But, I mean, this is sort of the thing they talk about, the paintbrush thing. When you can do anything, you end up doing nothing. Zack Snyder can do whatever he wants. And I get when he was making the film and then his daughter committed suicide, I don't think his head was completely in this movie. I don't think he was completely invested. And I still don't think he's completely invested in the movie. I still think there's a disconnect between Snyder and this, because, I mean, it's very strange to me that, you know, because people were like, the Snyder cut doesn't exist, and it really didn't exist. That's the thing. People are starting to say, well, all of you said that the Snyder cut doesn't exist and it'll be released. They're giving him the money and time to finish the Snyder cut. It was never actually completed. And people seem to forget that that was the rumor for a long time, was that there was a completed version of the Snyder Cut and they just didn't release it. He never really got to finish the movie to begin with. So I don't want to hear that crap. Like, it isn't like it was there and then they released it. And Folding Ideas made a great point that Snyder fans pretend to be DC fans to fight against Marvel fans. And this is so true, because I prefer DC to Marvel as a comic book reader. I prefer that the grandeur of DC. I prefer that they treat their heroes like gods instead of trying to find the humanity in them, except maybe Batman. But, you know, most people, for a long time in sales, it was all the Marvel stuff. People preferred Spider-Man, especially X-Men. X-Men was the biggest selling comic book for years. Even the highest selling comic book of all time to this day is X-Men. Not now, but the one that, I think it sold like 10 million copies, X-Men 1 in the 90s. So, I love this thing about these Zack Snyder fans. They pretend, you see them on Twitter, they'll be on YouTube occasionally, but they're mostly on Twitter. These people that act like they're DC fans, that they love Batman and Superman and The Flash and Green Lantern. So they blindly defend Zack Snyder when they're just praising Zack Snyder stuff, and then they just shit on the Marvel movies. But you can tell they're not really comic book fans, but they're more, they like Zack Snyder's take on this material as opposed to actually wanting a more loyal adaptation of the material. Like, I don't know any Superman fan can say that Zack Snyder adapted Superman properly. And I get that you can have an alternative take on the character, but this is the most boring Superman. He hardly has any dialogue. He's not fun. He doesn't have the Boy Scout attitude. I mean, he's messed up the dynamics. You know, Superman should be a Captain America-esque character to Batman's cynicism. That should be the fun of seeing them go back and forth with each other. But Superman's an asshole too. And he spends so little time giving character development. Of course, there's going to be hints at philosophy here, religious allegory, references to paintings and stuff like that. Zack Snyder loves that stuff. He really is a pretentious filmmaker. And I don't like to overuse the word pretentious. I think it does get thrown out there a lot. But if you actually look up the definition of pretentious, Zack Snyder fits it perfectly, because when he is in interviews talking about these movies and his vision for it, when he has that thing at the panel where he's like, I'm already down the fucking road, you know, he just comes off like an immature, arrogant jerk. He comes off like a young fratty jock guy because he's trying to, you know, I'm all for if you want to make like a super complex, thematically deep superhero film with these characters. I think that would be awesome. He's just not the guy to do it. And I'm not saying that it's easy as well. I think it'd be very difficult to do that. But when I watched The Boys last year and how it parodied Zack Snyder's DC Universe and made fun of it and actually had much more thematic depth and better acting. The guy who plays Homelander gives a better performance than anyone in the DC Universe. I mean, that guy should win an Emmy every year for that performance. He's amazing. He really is. The Boys is brilliant. I love it. And it had imagery and moments that gave me more of a feeling of what I got reading Watchmen than anything Zack Snyder's done. Because Zack Snyder, with Batman v Superman, he was basically trying to go to the geopolitical themes of Watchmen and trying to do this post 9/11 thing. And once again, you can't totally blame Snyder. The studio has been involved with this and has affected his vision. But at the same time, you would think after the disappointment of Man of Steel financially and critically, and then once again with Batman v Superman, they would have handled something differently. But it's just, I don't even know why they're keeping Snyder around. I don't see the benefit to this. After Joker made the money it did, and after Wonder Woman and Aquaman made the money they did, you really don't need Zack Snyder anymore. We live in a post-Zack Snyder DC world. You could just keep making these standalone movies like Joker on a lower budget that can make $1 billion. That movie won Oscars. I mean, it's just what it is. Like, it's like the complete opposite end of the spectrum. You know, here's these $200 million movies that disappoint at the box office and get bad reviews. And then here's this low-budget movie. Well, not a low-budget movie, but low-budget for a comic book movie that wins two Academy Awards and is one of the most profitable films of last year. It's like the third or fourth most profitable. I think Joker made like $350 million in net profit for the studio. I mean, it's crazy. Todd Phillips has a more successful track record with this stuff than Zack Snyder. And Zack Snyder claims to be the people of the fans, the man of the people. I get this stuff. I get comic books. I'm like the rest of you. I grew up reading graphic novels. I love Dark Knight Returns. Just because you're a fan doesn't mean you're the one that should be handling the material. That just means that you're a fan of it, and that's it. You know, there's no coincidence that the best movie Zack Snyder ever made was written by James Gunn, and every movie he made after that had diminishing returns. And I know a lot of people like Watchmen, and I even like a lot about Watchmen. I love the Rorschach stuff. I like the Dr. Manhattan stuff. But he's gotten worse since Watchmen. I mean, if those movies he's made recently were as good as Watchmen, I would give a lot of this a pass. But when he doesn't have the source material to pull from like he did from Watchmen, you just keep getting these mediocre movies, and they just can't hold up to something like Infinity War. They just can't. You know, Marvel just did this so much better. And the studio is a big reason for this. It's not all Snyder's fault. Bringing in Whedon and trying to reshoot a bunch of the movie and editing it into a mess, that was all a bad idea. I mean, I'm not saying that that wasn't a bad idea, but at the same time, I just don't think this is going to get the numbers they're hoping for. I mean, there's something so cynical about this. This would have never got released if it wasn't for HBO Max. They're just trying to put things on the streaming platform to get people to watch it. The Snyder Cut would have just stayed gone. You know, and the people who say to me, well, it's the most demanded director's cut in years. Well, how often do we have a director's cut that's demanded? The only director's cuts that can come to my head that really were super successful were like Blade Runner and Kingdom of Heaven, were like the Ridley Scott director's cuts. Like, they're saying, oh, people are demanding this. It's like, not really. There's a group of people that are demanding this, but it's not like the mass public is like, I really want to see the Snyder Cut of Justice League. I think most people have moved on. I don't think a lot of people give a shit about this movie. I think people are more interested in the new DC films. I don't think they care about the Ben Affleck, Henry Cavill universe. And I think it would benefit everybody if they recast Superman and a lot of these other characters and they just moved on to something else. I think it's time. It's time to move on. I think the standalone DC films that aren't a cinematic universe could make them different from Marvel to where they don't have to rely on the cinematic universe thing, which I think is better suited for DC Comics anyway. I think Marvel's comic book style is better suited for the serialized storytelling where I think DC could work better as standalone stories, like an Elseworlds tale or any kind of graphic novel in the universe. I think, you know, make a Batman movie, make a Joker movie, make a Green Lantern movie, and they could just be their own series and they don't have to keep running into each other. We don't need team-up movies where they're the Justice League. Maybe you can make one every 10 years or so, but I think DC would be better off to do more stuff that it's a self-contained story, and I think it would have benefited Zack Snyder. I think they gave him too much to do. They basically asked the guy to build a cinematic universe in two movies and then get to Justice League. Instead, he should have just made his Superman movie and then made a sequel to his Superman movie and then made a third movie to his Superman series and had a trilogy. And then somebody else could have done Batman and somebody else could have done the other characters. I mean, the fact that Zack Snyder had to introduce Wonder Woman, Aquaman, The Flash, Cyborg. I mean, it's too much to ask of one guy. It just is. It had to be overwhelming to him to try to get all these characters right, because then you're just seeing them all in his vision aesthetically, and you don't get to have different visions from other filmmakers coming together, which is what this needs to give each movie its own personality. For so long, the problem with the DC films was that they were all in the eyes of Zack Snyder. And then other filmmakers have to come into that world and try to play with it. And that just isn't easy to do. So then when Todd Phillips comes in and he makes, you know, a Martin Scorsese film aesthetically, and people go to it because it's unique, you'll get more appeal out of that instead of saying that everything has to look like a Zack Snyder movie. Even Wonder Woman in the third act is very Zack Snyder. And I'm hoping that they move on from this. Although this really is, if I'm trying to be optimistic here, because I don't like how this looks. I think it looks bad. I'm not a fan of the Zack Snyder films. At least for the fans out there that want to see this, credit to Warner Brothers for releasing this and putting this on HBO Max for those people. Like, these people get to be very happy that they're going to get the Snyder cut that they've always wanted. And I really have to give a lot of credit to Warner Brothers that they did this for those people so they could see what they wanted for the last few years. That's actually a really great gesture to the fans of these movies. It's not for me, and I understand that. So for anyone out there who's really excited about this, I'm happy for you. I really am. I'm happy that you get to see the movie that you wanted. Oh my god, what a poor choice in song. I mean, god, this just, once again, this look, it's just such a bad looking movie visually. I mean, that right there, that looks horrible. There's just too many special effects, this apocalyptic wasteland. I mean, I know they're trying to show stuff that wasn't in the movie, but can we see some of the cool stuff, like bad Superman or Superman in the black suit? I don't even know if it's going to be in the movie. That was my favorite part of the movie they released, was when Superman fought the Justice League. That's the coolest scene in the movie, where he turns his eye and looks at the Flash. And I've heard that Zack Snyder actually filmed that scene. I think originally it was at night, and then they changed it to a daytime scene, which was horrible. But that's the stuff I want to see. I want to see more of that. I don't want to see this stuff with the Flash that looks really bad. Like, just visual garbage. Like, this... Like can we get funny banter between the characters? Can we get more of a sense of what the storyline's going to be in this movie? Can we get a sense of the villains? Can we get some dialogue? I mean, show me some footage. It would have been better if they had just released a clip from the movie to really say, hey, this is what this movie's going to be like, you know, instead of just it looks like the trailers that were first coming out before Justice League was released. This reminds me of the first few trailers that came out for Justice League. This doesn't, like, make me go, oh my god, this looks so different. This looks very similar to the first trailers that we saw. Except this is that actual first Justice League trailer where the, you know, Cyborg's like, he says something to Batman like, I didn't even know you were real or something. And Batman's like, I'm real when I need to be. That was a cooler trailer than this trailer. That sold the movie a lot better than this trailer does. I mean, I know the hallelujah is there for the fans. Like, hallelujah, it's here. We got the Snyder Cut. Ezra Miller still doesn't know how to run. He waves his arms when he runs. That looks so bad. Why can't he do this? Did nobody ever teach this kid how to run? How did this get past? Like, how did they film this and not notice that his running looks stupid? I mean, it's so embarrassing how bad the running looks. Oh, there's our hero shot. Oh my god. I mean, it's cool to see all of them together. I do like these actors for the most part. I think Henry Cavill's not great as Superman, but I did like him in Mission Impossible and The Man from U.N.C.L.E. But man, this just doesn't. I'm mainly talking here about aesthetics, but this, I don't know how this is appealing to people. This looks like it was made 8 years ago or something. Like, this is really under par for a modern day movie. And Warner Brothers really has to be blamed for this. They did not budget this film well. They did not handle the post-production well. And I'm not putting this all on Zack Snyder. You have to blame the studio for this. It's like when Black Panther had the horrible special effects in it. I don't blame Ryan Coogler. The studio should... I mean, it's ridiculous that the final fight in Black Panther looks so fake. It's, you know... the Snyder cut.
This guy's probably fought hundreds of thousands of other super beings on the other planets he's destroyed, right? And we have to assume he's won.
I don't care how many demons he's fought and how many hells. He's never fought us. Not us united.
That's the only part I like. Even though Ben Affleck's like really going for it there, it's very cheesy. But I do like the Flash's point. They're like, hey, this guy's probably beat superheroes on other planets all over the universe. So what makes us special? Which really undersells the whole Justice League thing. Like, yeah, we may be the Justice League, but... And then Batman, I don't care how many demons and how many hells he's fought. He hasn't fought us together. That's pretty cool. But it is like cheesy B-movie cool. It's not like sophisticated cool or a really funny line of dialogue or something like that, you know. You know, like Tony Stark snapping and saying, I'm Iron Man. That's a really cool moment. I mean, it is like, this is like Commando level, you know, which I'm cool with. I just kind of wish Zack Snyder sometimes would just make dumb action movies like that are 2 hours long. And I think he'd be a really fun filmmaker. But this is just too much going on in this. You could tell that this movie is overly complicated when it could be streamlined. A smaller movie would be much better. One reason I think the first Avengers film did so well, even though visually I don't like that film, is that Joss Whedon did treat it like a television show, like a TV pilot. It's mainly people sitting in like on a carrier for most of the movie talking, and they have lines going back and forth. And that's why that movie was a hit. For 2 hours of it, for the most part, it's just the actors playing off of each other with funny banter. And then the last like 30 minutes, you get a big action sequence like in a Michael Bay movie. I think that they don't see that with these DC films. You don't get enough time with Batman playing off Superman. You don't get enough time with Wonder Woman and them all playing off of each other. It should be that, you know, most of my favorite stuff in the comic books isn't the action scenes. It's not the big epic action moments. It's the character relationships. That's why the Paul Dini... Bruce Timm stuff is so good in Batman the Animated Series or the Justice League, especially Justice League Unlimited, is that it's very much, and they were influenced by Joss Whedon, by the way, they've said as such, is that it's just about, you know, clever banter back and forth, and then having, that's why you can have great arcs with the Question and so on and those things. And with these Snyder films, he just loves the action so much. He loves the operatic nature of it. He loves the scale of it. That he misses a lot of those little moments that make your movie special and give it a humanity. I like seeing Jeremy Johns over there in the corner, like he's like, yeah, the Snyder cut. So here we are on Twitter, Zack Snyder being Zack Snyder, where he's a fucking asshole. And let me be clear, I'm not a fan of Scott Mendelson. Scott Mendelson, so the trailer for the Snyder cut of Justice League looks like the same movie? Yes, it does. Lots of deleted scenes from the marketing campaign, but otherwise it looks like an alternate take of existing scenes. Zach, you said you enjoyed the theatrical cut of Justice League like you enjoy Saturday morning cartoons. Yeah, a lot of really good Saturday morning cartoons, and I think that's what made the movie fun, was the movie they released was like watching a goofy, fun Saturday morning cartoon. And it had a very light tone to it. I think you could show kids that movie and they would enjoy it. And I think that was what was surprising about it, was that it wasn't so dark and nihilistic and boring like your movies. Then Zach says, well, this is made for grown-ups, so you're not in the demographic. Also, cool of you to comment on a leaked teaser. Like, why would you respond this way, dude? You just make yourself look bad. When you watch Batman v Superman and did the commentary, it's terrible. Every time he talks at a panel at any Comic-Con or event, it's horrible. And then to say, well, this is made for grown-ups. It's that Patrick Willems thing. This is a movie about space wizards made for children. This is so condescending. Like, this is a movie made for intelligent adults. I don't want kids to see my Justice League movie. This is going to be a hardcore adult movie. What the fuck is wrong with you? Like, these are the musings of a narcissist. I mean, this is like a Trump tweet or something. I mean, it's funny if you put sad at the end or something with an exclamation mark. This is made for grown-ups. I mean, that's so funny. I don't agree, Zach. I respect your opinion as a human being, though. I think you need to apologize so no bad blood is between you two. All due respect, why do you keep presuming I'm your enemy? Not every comment thing is thing good or thing bad, because Zack Snyder thinks very simplistically about everything. When did we reach a point in our society where a film critic doing their actual job was a basis to pile on and attack them? You talk about a film for grown-ups while acting like a petulant child yourself. Great response. Petulance is the exact right word. Damn, this is so true. Unnecessary dark theme and destruction along with the forced religious symbolism. Classic Snyder. It's impressive to me that a maker has a theme that becomes his or her signature. There'll be a few who'd find destruction, symbolism, dark thing relatable, and few just move on without even watching it. But many say it out loud because they need people to agree with them. Validation? I think Zack Snyder's insecure. I think the criticism has gotten to him. Every time someone dings at your ego, you throw a tantrum like a child, would then scream, "Well, it's for grown-ups!" Take your own advice and a few filmmaking courses. Remember the last time he chatted? Please don't make me get into this with you. By the way, Zach is at an insane expert level when it comes to filmmaking. Have you worked with him before? Why would you have to work with him? He is not at an expert level at filmmaking. He is basically a technical guy. Yes, he has a great understanding of lenses and lighting and all of that. But you can watch a low-budget indie film. Let me bring up Rian Johnson, who I know is hated today. Rian Johnson made the movie Brick for like $400,000. Go back and watch that movie. That movie looks like it cost $1 million, you know, and I love that movie. Or Christopher Nolan made Memento for $5 million. Go back and watch that movie. Zack Snyder's making $200 million movies, and visually, they're less interesting than his Dawn of the Dead remake. Have you worked on any film production before? Do you even know what a director... Yes, we all know what a director does. You moron. Please save your I went to film score for them, an expert at film BS. You either do it because you're some dude on YouTube crying about the success of others. Zack Snyder hasn't been successful. He's had movies that are major failures. Are you telling me Sucker Punch was successful? Also, I love that the argument here is that don't tell me you're a film student and you're acting like an expert when you're pretending that Zack Snyder's an expert just because he works in Hollywood and there's no way that he can make a bad movie. I met Spike Lee once, and his advice to everyone about being a good filmmaker was learn how to tell a story. He said telling the story will lead you to making a good movie. It'll reinforce the shots and everything that you're doing. That's the best advice I ever got because it's so simple. Storytelling is what you're doing here. You can make something look good. There's a lot of great like music video directors and commercial directors, and that's really what Zack Snyder is. He's sort of more in the vein of like a Tony Scott. But he hasn't made a True Romance. He hasn't made a Crimson Tide. You know, I never went to film school or even animation school. But you know what I did? I honey my craft on my own, learning from the best and working with the best. I'm doing this long enough called BS when I see it. No, you haven't, because this looks like shit. I think this movie is going to break the record of Avengers because it's directed by the best director ever. Disregarding everything else, I find this tweet hilarious because the best representation of the Justice League we've ever gotten was from an actual Saturday morning cartoon. 100%. Justice League and Justice League Unlimited is still to this day my favorite superhero adaptation probably ever. I also am a big fan of Unbreakable and American Splendor, but isn't a superhero movie. Honestly, the problem seems to be you. You don't have a good track record in the DCU. Both Man of Steel and Batman Superman were average at best. Making things gritty doesn't automatically make an adult man. Making things gritty makes a movie teenagers think is adult, but in a lot of instances actually makes it feel more sophomoric. I'm going to make Thanos my bitch. DC, I already made Marvel my bitch through just Snyder's. Yeah, sure. Yeah, this is going to be as successful as Infinity War and Endgame were, you know, the highest grossing movie of all time. No, Darkseid does look terrible. Avatar is a Saturday morning cartoon. Gargoyles is a Saturday morning cartoon. DCAU is comprised of Saturday morning cartoons, all of them far deeper, meaningful, and adult than your Batman is now a serial killer shit. Well, the Saturday morning cartoon thing, I get what he's saying. But it still like kind of misses the point, since you do not understand. The message here is that cartoons given examples have more depth and meaning while aimed at kids, and the movie made for grown-up has about as much meaning as an early morning dump. Oh my god, look at Zach doing that. Look, that's the kind of guy he is. He always just looks like such a jack-off in everything I've ever seen him do. Like, I think he has too much fun. I think he is too childish and in love with what he's doing, that he doesn't take it seriously enough. I don't think he works hard enough. I really don't think he works hard enough. I don't think he sits down with the writing and the scripting and rewrites and rewrites and rewrites and works on it and really thinks these things out. I think he just goes in there like a kid playing with his toys and like, I'm going to fight this guy versus this guy. I think people think that he like works really hard. I think he actually, because he is talented and he can make a good looking movie visually. So I think he just goes in and shoots it and does what he wants to do. And he doesn't think about coherence and a running theme. I think he actually doesn't want to put the hard work in to actually make a really good movie. I really believe that. You know, for a movie made for grown-ups, your Watchmen adaptation literally removed Omar every deep or meaningful adult concept from the source material. You're also literally working with the DCIP, which does not allow for real shit, usually. Why are you surprised? My rabbit over here is making weird noises. Oh my god. Poor Ben Affleck. He almost killed himself with alcohol because of these movies. You almost killed Ben Affleck, Zach. Stop killing people. Yeah, I like how they're acting like Zach had this like great comeback. Really well said, boss. Super hyped to watch your panel and the trailer. I honestly don't know what's up with this guy. He's got some sort of agenda that disregards facts against the Snyder Cut. Very weird. I don't think he has an agenda. I think he was just stating his opinion. And if you don't think that Zack Snyder fans don't have an agenda, which they've made very clear, don't give me that crap. I think we should have a much better state of entertainment journalism now if more people did that. If they just got in silly fights on Twitter. The way to do it is to ignore the critics and let the work for it speak for itself. When you defend yourself like this, it seems like you're letting it get to you. Like, people leave negative comments on my videos all the time, and sometimes I respond very casually, like, well, hey, I get what you're saying, or I try to explain something to them, but people are going to criticize your shit. That's just how it works. If you put your stuff out there and make, it's not like Zack Snyder didn't get paid to do this. You know, film critics don't owe him anything. You'll never understand Superman or any other member of the Justice League. Darkness and grittiness do not equal good storytelling. I mean, I've always just felt like Zack Snyder was like the Rob Liefeld of superhero movies. That's really what he reminds me of, is 90s Rob Liefeld stuff. And that stuff was popular for a while, and it doesn't sell anymore. And that's just sort of Zack Snyder. He's just irrelevant in the world of modern-day superhero movies and television shows. You know, I think 10, 15 years ago, the stuff he was doing was really cool for a lot of people. I remember being a teenager at the time, and it was really cool for me. Like, 300 was a really cool movie. I try to watch 300 now, and it's just so ridiculous that it's hard to even sit through. It's hilarious. But, you know, at the time, that was a cool movie. Guess you haven't watched The Boys on Amazon Prime. Watch the first episode. There's tights, but you know it isn't for kids. Yeah, but The Boys is like the good version of Zack Snyder's DC Universe. Like, that's what I'm saying. The Boys did a better job, and Dan Trachtenberg did a better job directing that. Because that is what Snyder talks about. I'm going to make this adult film. The Boys has sex in it, hardcore violence, does deal with terrorism, political intrigue, an overbearing government, experiments on children, revenge. It's awesome. The most gratuitous moments in that show, or shocking moments, remind me of early Game of Thrones. And it just shows that Zack wasn't willing to commit to going far enough to him making the adult superhero films he claimed he wanted to make, or that the studio didn't want to go that way, or that Zack just couldn't do it. And the people who are working on The Boys, in particular Aaron Kripke, the guy who did Supernatural, is just a better writer. Yeah, that looks, I mean, exactly. This looks like an Xbox cutscene. don't judge something. Everyone always says that. The movie's still a year out. Don't judge the special effects on a teaser. It's not going to look that much better in the final product. They've been calling him different names, attacking him on everything he does. Then they spread his personal life, family, and dead daughter in the last 6 years. But him clapping back once in a while is losing his shit. Why? Hypocrisy? Hypocrisy is just human nature. Zack Snyder's a hypocrite as much as anyone. He kind of deserves it, though. He doesn't take criticism well at all. Any form of logical and objectively wrong thing he does with the film or depiction of the character comes his way. He blames it on fans and viewers. Yeah, he always says that. He said that I'm down the road, like, you're not growing up enough to understand where my superhero films are, that they've moved on down the road, and you're still stuck in this level, which is insulting to people like me who've been reading comic books most of my life. Like, I don't even know what the fuck he's talking about. Also, who cares if a trailer gets leaked, Zach? Trailers get leaked all the time. Why are mainstream people like this acting like the internet doesn't exist? This is like the mainstream media acting like YouTube isn't relevant. Oh my god. It's about how beating people up is really cool, so you should make it slow motion and erotic at the same time. That's what adults like. He is a very smart director who definitely understands the things he makes movies about. Yeah, that's an adult movie. This is all very adult. I mean, I don't really get... I think it's more aimed towards teenagers than grown-ups. I don't even know what that grown-ups comment means. Like, is it going to be rated R? Oh my goodness. I mean, the Zack Snyder memes are funny. I'm not going to act like there isn't something funny about Snyder fans posting memes like he's awesome. Even though, really, he is a failure. That's the funniest thing about the whole Zack Snyder thing that I love the most, is that he has this fan base that acts like he's this misunderstood artistic genius, when the rest of us, who, you know, just watch it and see that the guy's not that person, that he's not some genius filmmaker artist. He's a very shallow filmmaker. And we all see that, and then these people defend the guy, but then his movies disappoint financially, they're going to continue to get bad reviews, and then other filmmakers are successful without him. You know, James Wan is a much more successful director than Zack Snyder on all fronts. Let's go back to the whole visual expert thing. James Wan made Saw on a budget of $1 million, and the movie made $100 million, and it's a pretty good-looking movie for that budget. But... I love that these people defend Zack Snyder. They'll be in the comments of this video, I just know it. They'll try to tell me, like, all the themes that I'm missing and how this line of dialogue attaches to this and things that Zack Snyder has, and that I don't like a mature, serious, dark superhero film. They'll say all that crap. They'll defend this guy, and I don't understand it. I don't know if it's trolling. I mean, how insecure do you have to be to just ignore the numbers? If Zack Snyder was like a baseball player, a football player, he would have horrible numbers. Like, he would just have a terrible, like, scoring average. And these people would be like, no, you don't get it. I know that, you know, he never makes any shots in a game, or he never hits the ball, but he's really the best player on the team. I mean, it's insane to me. They just defend this guy, and they try to connect it to being a DC fan and a Marvel fan. They make it like it's somehow connected to the whole... People do this with the Star Wars sequels as well. If you don't like the Star Wars sequels, they attack you and create a lot of the vitriolic nature between the two things. And that's the most stunning thing about it to me. He loved the DCAU and even collaborated with Bruce Timm on a Superman animated short in 2013 that paid respects to all versions of the character. Well, then why didn't he bring those guys in to write that? Why has WB never let Paul Dini write a Justice League movie? No, these guys are like finish him, boss. I mean, they love this dude. They love this frat boy asshole who is a bad writer. I mean, this is like if people loved Michael Bay and said Transformers 4 and 5 were great movies. I mean, it's insane. It's a fair statement. It's Zack attack. There's a Zack on attack. I got a Zack on my back. Dun 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 dun. Oh my goodness. Wrestling. No, it's like these are like people who love WWF. I love the Zack Snyder fan base. They're amazing. They're so funny. They bring me so much joy. Oh my god. The best time to delete this tweet was immediately after sending it. It's the second best time is now. Local man is fucking invincible. Oh my God, Meryl Streep. That's, oh my God. Are you seeing people can't enjoy cartoons and movies? I love that people are trying to flip the Saturday morning cartoon thing like that. I mean, guys, Zach Comet was not clever. That is not a great clapback to say, well, you said you liked it like a Saturday morning cartoon. Well, this is made for... Imagine if you were sitting there arguing with the guy in person and he said that. Instead of saying a really articulate, smart thing to him, you know, like really going into like, well, no, this is what I'm trying to do. This is what happened. This means a lot to me. And I think you're not being fair. You're not giving it a chance. Instead, he says, well, you said you liked the movie like a Saturday morning cartoon, which was a compliment. Well, this is made for grown-ups, all right? I mean, it's just, that's the worst comeback ever. That's how lame these Zack Snyder fans are. They don't know how to meme. They're like the left. They don't understand. Like, you think that's a good comeback? It's fucking terrible. Trailer looked amazing, beyond excited for Justice League. Love Batman versus Superman. Just remember that Twitter is very loud, hateful minority of people. These movies have a huge fan base out there. Not really. When you compare how much money they put into these, it's a very small fan base when you compare it to so many other franchises that are out there. Especially considering that it's Batman and Superman. I mean, holy shit, do I have to bring up Joker again? Yeah, it's perfectly fine to be critical of Zack Snyder fans. Zack Snyder fans are assholes, and they don't make good arguments. They make really bad arguments defending this guy, just instead of saying, you know, I get what you're saying, I get what you don't like it, but I like these movies. I'm okay with them. Those things don't bother me. Instead, they try to make these arguments from an intellectual standard. They're basically saying, I'm smarter than you and more mature than you by liking the Zack Snyder stuff, and you're not smart enough to understand it. That's typically the argument that Zack Snyder fans take. And it's a really bad argument. They also try to use like an argument from authority, which is a bad argument. The whole trailer is literally made of scenes not in the theatrical cut, and this guy comes in and only says alternate takes existing scenes. Every scene is missing adjusted. Yeah, but a lot of those scenes were in the trailer. That football scene, the flash glass thing, those shots were in the Justice League trailer that came out, like, what, 2 years ago? 3 years ago? You disrespect if someone else's passion is not required. Well, what's wrong with looking at a leaked trailer? Fuck this whole leaked trailer thing, you fucking normies. Oh my God. Oh my God, the trailer leaked. Oh no, people are watching it. It's not like they're pirating the movie. They're watching a leaked thing of promotional material. It was going to be put on the internet anyway. It doesn't matter. It only helps the movie if people watch the trailer. Like, a trailer getting leaked is not a big deal. I could see people having a problem with people torrenting a movie. But a fucking trailer leak? Like, are you kidding me? In 2020? It's ridiculous. Especially with COVID. Why didn't they just upload this? Yeah, it was the Dark Knight trilogy soulless or even... Please don't compare Zack Snyder to what Christopher Nolan did or what James Mangold did in Logan. You mean those successful, critically acclaimed movies that were well-written and made by better filmmakers? Like, and also, Logan and Dark Knight did have a lot of levity and fun to them. Zack Snyder has no pathos. His movies are heartless and soulless. That's one of the problems with them. They're very clinical. He has a really big disconnect with the humanity of his characters. Whedon tried to make the Avengers, and the reality is the Avengers assembles hands down the worst Marvel film. That's not even close. How is it worse than Thor: The Dark World? How is it worse than Age of Ultron? How is it worse than Captain Marvel? Iron Man 2 is a much worse film than the Avengers. No question. It's the most lazy writing I've seen in my entire life. Instead of putting actual effort into the good writing reason for Batman changing his ideology, they went with, let's just make of him something personal, common, is genuinely hilarious. Look for Whedon tried to make the Avengers, and the reality is... Yeah, I don't know if people think the Avengers 1 is the worst Marvel film. That's not true. A Snyder movie made for grown-ups. I guess there's a first time for everything. Scott Mendelson's ex. Yeah, I don't think Zack Snyder understands any storytelling medium. I don't think it's just comic books. I think it's all storytelling mediums. Exactly. Snyder fans act like whiny toddlers, and then they get mad at people, and then they say that you don't understand. That's the thing. Here's how you can help you guys. Let me give advice to you Snyder fans. Because I guess I need to wrap this up. This has become a laborious video at this point. Or the same people who defend Rian Johnson in The Last Jedi. You have to make better arguments. You have to make better arguments. You can't just, because you guys are also contributing to this. You're basically just mad that people hate the movie that you like, that there's a huge amount of people that don't like this franchise that you love. So you really have to dig in deep, make your video essays defending it, write your article online. You really have to go in and make good arguments. You have to show proof that Zack Snyder is competent in the writing. You have to find, because people, there's so many memes and things you could find about Zack Snyder that makes him look like an idiot. I mean, you're praising this tweet instead of saying, hey, Zach, this would be a better argument. And some people are doing that. Like, you can't back up this guy like this. You have to really dig deep and find a way to hold these up, because everything's against you. You know, these movies didn't make the money they were supposed to make. They didn't get good reviews. They were disliked by a lot of people. You could say at best that the reaction was mixed by the mainstream. So if you really love something and you have to fight for it, I want you to fight for it right. You know, just like the Star Wars sequels that, you know, and defending The Last Jedi and Force Awakens. You have to make better arguments. And you have to be willing to get into debates with the people that don't like it. And you have to have responses to their criticisms. You have to be able to explain away why Lois Lane throwing the spear into the water and then immediately going back to get it 5 minutes later, after she threw it in the water, and then Superman comes to save her, you have to explain how that isn't contrived and lazy writing. Because every metric that I can see, it is. But if you can explain to me how that's a clever, well-written scene, and it isn't lazy, contrived screenwriting, cool. But you guys never want to go into that. You always make these straw man arguments like, oh, people didn't like Last Jedi because it isn't what they wanted. They didn't like that it subverted your expectations. Instead of having the arguments about the plot, or you say, oh, you don't like that Zack made a serious, dark movie that's like this. You know, instead of saying, okay, well, this is why this scene is here. This is why this moment is here. Jesse Eisenberg's over-the-top performance as Luther is works because of this. You know, the Doomsday CGI isn't bad because of this. You have to really get into those arguments and make a good counter argument to that. But instead, most of the time, it just turns into basic internet banter. And then every time a new film comes out that's more successful than a Zack Snyder movie, which is almost every superhero film that comes out, like Captain Marvel made more money than this. I mean, it's embarrassing. It really is. It's embarrassing that a Superman, Batman, Superman movie and a Justice League movie made less money than Captain Marvel. And I don't even like Captain Marvel. I think it's a pretty bad movie too. So I get like being there's something about being the underdog, and I root for the underdog. Like, you guys are the Rocky, you know? But if you want those arguments, then you have to like set a standard that other people have to meet. You know, because you guys have to accept that you're in the bottom position and you have to get up here. You can't just say, well, I'm up here and you guys don't understand. That's the take that Zack Snyder has. You have to elevate the material yourselves. But then you end up writing the movie for the filmmaker, which is what a lot of people do. They just add themes and complexities that obviously weren't there. So then that becomes an issue in itself. So just make better arguments, make your video essays, what have you, and defend this stuff. Tell me why this stuff is good. Because all I see with this trailer is another overblown, too much CGI, too much color grading, too much self-seriousness, overstuffed plot, too many characters, too many things going on. This just looks like your typical DC Zack Snyder film. I mean, do you really think this stuff's going to have huge emotional weight, like Cyborg's father, the whole death thing and him being upset about his father dying? You don't think that's going to be like a 10-minute thing, or the girl with it? I mean, even 4 hours may not be long enough. It seems like Zack Snyder just wants to do television shows. Like, this should be 10 hours for the stuff he wants to do. So, I mean, all I'm seeing here is this just looks like another Zack Snyder movie. And this would have bombed at the box office. Even if they hadn't changed anything about it, if they would have released this movie in two parts, Justice League 1 and Justice League 2, it still would have bombed. Because there isn't the demand for this that you think there is. And I'm not saying that financial success equals quality, because that is certainly not true. Not at all. But at the same time, it's just gotten to the point that it's become ridiculous that we still have to even put up with this Zack Snyder thing. I would really like for Zack Snyder to go away and do something else so we can all move on. The Snyder fans and the non-Snyder fans, so we can all move on and enjoy superhero comic book stuff in our own way and just leave this shit behind. Like Zack said, let's go down the road. Zack, let it go. All right? You're just not the guy. I know you want to be the main guy. You want to be the leader of the comic book revolution, and you're not. You had your moment in the sun. You were a big deal when 300 came out, and it's over. Maybe go make a low-budget film for like $10 million and go back to why you wanted to be an artist in the first place. I would like to see Zack Snyder be successful. There'd be nothing I'd love more than if Zack Snyder made a really, really good movie that was an original movie that wasn't based off anything. But he's just never going to let this go. The hubris is just too much. And he keeps getting support from these fans. And all it does is let people make videos that shit on it. Or Twitter fights, and it's all press, and it's all hype, just so HBO can get viewers to watch this, so people will subscribe to their streaming service. It's so cynical that I'm just kind of flabbergasted by the whole thing. But what do I know? I'm only 30 years old, so maybe when I get a little bit older, I'll understand these movies and why they're so great. I'd ask in the comments section, If you can honestly go into why these films are good, that would be interesting, but I feel like a lot of people are just going to use this to attack each other. Well, why don't you actually go into why Zack Snyder movies are good? And why you think this is going to be a good movie? I'm interested. I'm open to hear it. I don't want to debate with you. Like, tell me why. Because I really haven't heard a good argument for this. I really, really haven't, and the trailer did not sell me on this. And it's really hurt by the fact that all of the other trailers they released are far superior to this one.